Thank you, everyone. Some nameless grunt in 1969 in Binh Dinh Province, Vietnam, said this: "There are three kinds of people, bro. Those who don't know, those who don't care, and those who survive." Well, all of us here know. All of us here care. And all of us here will survive. There is a wall in Washington, D.C. that has the names of over 59,000 of my brothers and sisters engraved on it. The names identify people, American men and women, human beings who died in Vietnam. These Americans gave their bodies, their very corporal selves, to the war. They had skin in the game. The Supreme Court of the United States of America, in two unconstitutional and anti-human rulings, Buckley versus Vallejo in 1976 and Citizens United versus the Federal Election Commission in 2010, gave corporate personhood to the Wall Street businesses and their multi-global cables. The idea that businesses and their CEOs and boards of directors can have representation as we, the people, is an abomination. They want to use their money and wealth to buy, bribe, and corrupt the human representatives of the people, and they have no skin in the game. The corporations cannot be drafted into the service. They cannot lose an arm, a leg, an eye, or their soul. They cannot be poisoned by chemicals and drugs, die slowly from cancer or diabetes, nor descend into depression and commit suicide. They cannot be sentenced to years of incarceration for crime committed against men, women, and children, such as Union Carbide in Bhopal, India. They do not suffer. They do not bleed. They do not weep tears of rage and guilt. Well, we are here today, know, and we care, and we will survive. And I, as a combat veteran of Vietnam and a father of four daughters, a husband of 41 years, will not abide nor ever accept that Wall Street and the military-industrial complex deserve personhood, not until they put their skin in the game.